Hi, I'm Graham West, and here's 20 tips to keep you catching on the feeder this winter. So, in summer, 50-50 method and paste green, perfect for me. Lots of high protein in there, lots of pellets. But when it comes to winter, we need to scale it down a little bit. Not so much feed, but really fish mealy smell. F1 dark, super sweet. The sweet is drags them little skimmers in, which is what we're aiming this time of year. It's freezing cold, the water's 5 degrees today. Water temperature is probably about 4 degrees. It's been icy all week, so now I'm heading for that fine, sweet fish mealy ground bait. This time of year, it's not about filling the fish up, so I like to put all my ground bait mixes through the new 3mm reel from Preston. A nice, fine mix. If you have to keep casting, you're having a good day, you know that your mix hasn't got lots and lots of particles in. It's very fine, and it'll keep them fish feeding, looking for your hook bait. For me, winter, natural baits rule. Worms, red worms, maggots, pinkies, casters. Fantastic baits. You can use them singly, single dead red maggot, single dead pinky. Absolutely superb catching these little skimmers. Over the last 5 or 6 years, it's all been about dead baits, dead maggots, dead pinkies. But over some fantastic days, fishing with live maggots, single live maggots, double red maggots, double white maggots, all live maggots. It's not always about the dead, so be prepared to use live maggots too. Worms have been a stable diet for bream and skimmer fishing for the last, well, as long as I can remember. However, they don't always want to eat worms. So in my opinion, the best way is to feel your way in gently with them. When feeder fishing, them fish will let you know, it will be an instant response, whether they want to eat worms or not. If they don't, stop putting them in, but your bites will either increase or they'll stop. That will tell you whether they want worms or not. So just go gently. As the weather goes cold, catching little skimmers and bream through the winter, rod choice is absolutely paramount. Supera SL 10 foots and 11 foots are absolutely perfect for the job. Light lines, small hooks, they're so soft they don't pull the hooks out. Absolutely perfect choice for this sort of fishing. Line choice is a very important decision to make for every angler this time of year. If braid is allowed, then I will use braid. 010 absolute braid is absolutely perfect as long as I use it with a shock leader. If braid's not allowed, there's only one choice for me. Preston sinking feeder mono, absolutely perfect. For me, 023 sinking feeder mono, abrasion resistant, low stretch, fantastic knot strength. Rigs, for me, keep it as simple as possible, as you can see. Snap link swivel, a line protector bead, twizzle boom, a quick change hook link swivel. Now, the reason I use one of them, because it stops me being lazy. If I'm thinking I need to fish a shorter hook length, it's so quick to change a hook length, rather than have to use a double loop system, cut your hook length off, this is just so easy. You can have a new hook length on within 6 seconds, simple as that. So don't be lazy, make it easy. One thing that's overlooked is your quiver tip choice for feeder fishing in the winter. You need to take in what the conditions are on the day. If you're fishing a shallow lake and it's blowing a hoolie, if you put a really soft tip in, the toe on the lake will pull your tip round, will be very hard to see bite. So aim for a slightly heavier tip. On the other end of the scale, let's go the other way. If it's flat calm and you're looking for little bites, the softest tip is the best way to see your bites. Yeah. This time of year, it's quite often very windy. And the last thing you want is a feeder arm that's not very strong. These new off-box feeder arms are absolutely perfect, strong and sturdy. because you don't want that tip bouncing around when it's windy and not seeing your bites. Accuracy is key. There's lots of things on the markets now to make sure that we can be as accurate as possible. Paramount for me, distance sticks. Use your line clip and always look for a far bank marker that you cast to. For me, hook choice in the winter, simple. SFLBs, super sharp, nice fine gauge wire. They make your bait presentation perfect, yet they're strong enough to hook them bigger bream, or if you're lucky enough to even hook a carp. I like to feed two lines in winter, and these three feeders. The bullet feeder to get me distance. As soon as you get a side crosswind, that bullet helps that feeder fly through the water so you know you're gonna hit your clip every single time. But only three holes, you're not feeding a lot of bait, so absolutely perfect. The other line I changed between the ICM Mini, which feeds hardly any bait at all, and if I want to increase bait, put some worms through, I'll use the three hole cage feeder because it's a bit bigger and can take a little bit more bait to get some bait out on the bottom. In winter, for me, it's really simple. Two lines. One on the short line, which will be anywhere between 14 to 18 metres on the line where people fish poles all summer. Then fishing used to being fed on that line, on that pole line. So that's a great place to have a feeder line in winter. The fish are used to being there, so they'll come and feed on that short line. But to catch on that short line, you need to fish another line at the start. So I will choose a line between 30 to 35 metres, fish that line for as long as I possibly can, or whilst I'm getting bites, to allow that short line time to settle. To feed that short line, I like to use a bigger feeder and a separate rod. However, when you're baiting up, you like to keep your rod in a straight line and keep your line as tight to your feeder so that you can strike the bait out really quickly and leave the bait on the bottom. Because of that, you need to make sure that when you clip up using your measuring sticks, that your bait up feeder rod is at a shorter length than your feeder. If you had it at the same distance on your measuring sticks, when you cast your feeder out to fish, you always wind on 1 or 2 meters of line onto your reel. So bear that in mind. Make sure that on your baiting up rod, you're clipped up 2 meters shorter than the distance that you're actually fishing on your feeder. Bites can be very delicate in the winter. And one way of getting a proper bite is to fish slack lines. If you're getting fishing a tight tip and you're getting little digs all the time, just move that rod towards the feeder and make that line a little bit slacker. They'll feel no resistance and it'll make them confident to take that hook a bit better. I am the king of comfort. So you need to do everything you possibly can to keep yourself dry and warm in the winter. When you're not getting many bites, there's nothing worse than being uncomfortable. Comfort is paramount. If you're comfortable and you're warm, you fish 100%. So I never leave home without my brolly. I get up to the side to keep that cold wind off me. Always have a flask. And I've also been known to carry a little burner with me. So as long as you stay nice and warm, that is the main thing. Now, if you follow me on Facebook and you follow my blog through the winter, you will know that I always say it's not over till the fat lady sings. And patience feeder fishing in the winter is absolutely important. Matches are quarter for one in the last hour. Now, you just need to keep your nerve and be patient. Patience is so important this time of year when feeder fishing. Lots of matches that we fish, we're here. I've caught 4 bream in the last hour. But you need to be patient and you need to remember that at some time in this match, the fish are gonna feed. But you just need to keep your head level and know that it's not over till the whistle goes. Right, my final tip of the day. And I shouldn't really be telling you this because it's gonna take away my little edge. But when you clip up your feeders to fish at 30 meters or 18 meters, once you've put them on your sticks, backwinder to add another 2 meters on to that distance, put a clip on, then wind back to your 18 meter or your 30 meter line and put the clip on. What it does is that sometimes in your session, you can unclip at the 18 metre line and start to fish 2 metres past your feed. That has won me so many matches over the years by unclipping and moving 2 metres past my feed. That's my final tip of the day. If you've had a good day and you're catching a few fish, but all of a sudden in the last sort of hour they've started to drift off, you think the fish have gone, there's nothing better than a lovely bunch of red worms. 3 or 4 on a hook can sometimes bring you 3 or 4 proper fish that have been sitting just off your feed all day, enough to come in and take that big bunch of worms. So try them.